And I'm back with another session. And yes, today I'm wearing a shirt. You know why? Because today we are going to have an entrepreneurial, a business conversation with a very special guest who I met during the worst crisis of the past 100 years. And Joe is one of the most special people. Joe gave me that hope in the very first time that we connected. And Joe is one of the best persons I've met through online networking. And and I've been waiting for this session for quite some time. And I'm very excited. Joe is currently the CEO of the venture Start, Grow, Manage, which is based in New York in United States. And Start, Grow, Manage, as the name itself speaks a lot about it, but it's a company which provides entrepreneurs and freelancers tools and courses to help them thrive. I welcome you, Joe. Is there anything you want to say about Joe, the entrepreneur, that, you know, maybe we should say before getting into the question answers?
I don't know. I don't think so. But I just wanted to say thank you for having me on. And, you know, I really appreciate you and appreciate your spirit. I love, all the conversations we've had have been really great. And I just wanted to say thanks.
That's great.
Roll, babe. Bring it on.
Bring it on. So this is something that I was just telling Joe, but we were not recording, but I say this on camera, that relationship building is like a tree, and networking is one of the major branches. And what I see is what is unique about Joe is that Joe does really well in the tree itself. So networking and communication skills are just branches of this relationship building. My question is, Joe, how do you manage to bring a significant positive change in the business operations and freelancers who are hustling when, you know, every 3 to 6 months there is something new to learn?
Yeah, it's really great. And that word hustling, you know, the business operations hasn't changed much in the last 100 years, right? But there's this hustle that everybody, have you ever looked up that word in a dictionary?
It means to like push hard when things are kind of difficult. So, for example, if I'm doing a leg workout and I can feel that my muscles are sore, but I still want to do one more set or maybe two more sets.
That's push, right? But if you look up hustle in the dictionary, here's what you're going to find: for someone to specify direct. So, to obtain by first, to pressure someone into doing, sell by illicit action, to swindle or to cheat. So I'm not a big fan of hustling.
Okay.
I like building, right? So question, which is positive change to business operations, is that get people to stop hustling. Because when you're hustling, you're just trying to get it done by force. And what you really want to do is you want to build a machine, right? That does the, and it takes time and it takes some particular skills to do the. Is we try to show people those skills and try to talk to them about not hustling. They want to hustle because they think hustling is good. But in the end, hustling just makes you tired and broke, right? Because you end up just working more hours than everybody else and grinding and doing all this crazy stuff. And what we're saying is, don't do that. It's not good for your mental health. So to bring that positivity, you have to take care of your mind.
Okay, that's an interesting perspective. Like, so basically what you're trying to say is that hustling is like a word which is often misused. And it's like, if I want to go down to the park or the beach, I say, oh, no, work, work, work. And then I don't
gotta
really
hustle,
get to
gotta
enjoy
hustle.
The process. Yeah, yeah. Come on, work. Boom, boom, boom. It's like, so you're someone who kind of believes more in enjoying the process. And I've seen on one of your LinkedIn posts how you share some pictures of you spending time with your family. I think that really gives a very good example to the youth and to, you know, people of your age that yes, there is business, there is jobs, there is freelancing, there is all these things, but it's also important to acknowledge personal life, because in a way, whatever we do is boils back to having a better personal life. I mean, that's one of the objectives of doing well professionally, is that, you know, to take care of survival, not just survival, but also well-being.
Yes. Yes. And so part of that is really setting yourself up for that, setting yourself up to be well, you know, you have to take care of you. You have to take care of you. You have to take care of your family. You have to, those are things that you need to do if you want to really, if you really want to thrive, you have to take care of yourself. And what I see with a lot of small business owners is that they don't take care of themselves. They beat themselves up to death, right? They grind themselves to death. And that's a function of not having a well-running business. They go from being employees to being self-employed, but they never build a business. And so it's, how do you build a business that helps you really enjoy your life? That's the whole point of being in business, not working more hours and getting paid less.
Yeah. I think from my personal experience, I can say this, because there was a time when I used to just be working all the time. I used to just be reading, watching videos on personal development and spirituality. And there was this one phase where my mind became all about numbers. How many hours did I work? And I would have, like, you know, I would have quick new deals, cook it in like 5 minutes, spend another 2 or 3 minutes to eat it, because I thought cooking was giving me less time to work and to be on the hustling mode. But in reality, that's what killed my productivity. If I didn't do that, I would remember more stuff that I maybe read last year, because I would have had a sharp memory and I would have enjoyed the process.
Yeah, yeah. So you have to make sure you take time to sleep. Sleep is important, you know. Yes. 7-8 hours of sleep is good. You know, make sure that you eat properly, make sure you exercise. You know, I take about 4 15-minute walks a day during the day. I exercise a couple of times during the day. It keeps me, you know, I wear comfortable clothes. I like being comfortable. I like being, you know.
You seem like a person who works out regularly. Do you go to the gym every morning?
No,
like
I work
the
out.
The first thing that you do is this, and then everything becomes easy. Do you believe in that?
I used to go to the gym all the time. Then after COVID, I bought all the equipment and now I just work out, you know, so I just work out at home and I have stuff in the office also. So I work out here. We're actually redoing the office in a couple of months. And so I'm setting up the gym space even a little bit more. So that we'll have like a separate, I have some equipment here, but I'll have like a separate gym area set up in the office. And it's really, you know, that's the whole shebang.
I can actually tell from your t-shirt and from your skin that there is something good that is happening within you, and that reflects. Because the other day I saw this video that, you know, the human skin, the skin basically reflects what is inside. So if there are too many toxins inside my body, I'm not going to be having a very glowing skin. And when I see you, I can tell, okay, something is happening the way it should be. And that is why I can see your skin really glows. And the fitting of your t-shirt, I can tell that, you know, you're a person who is not just like working out once a week, but even if you do maybe 20, 30 minutes daily, but it shows that you are consistent. Because consistent people have a more athletic kind of a body 365 days.
Oh, cool. But that's, you know, so I think that part of, to go back to your question, really, Pat, part of good, of the good maintenance of your business is good maintenance of you as the entrepreneur that's running the business, right? So if you take care of you, you can take care of the business better.
Yeah, that's a fact. What do you like to learn in your free time? So it's like, how does Start, Grow, Manage, Start Joe, Grow Joe, and Manage Joe Rogers? And what are your hobbies outside work?
Good. So in the business, I like to learn mindset stuff. I like to learn budgeting. I like to learn how the fundamentals of the business work, you know. Outside the business, I like to learn all kinds of stuff. I sculpt. So I like different sculpting techniques or sculpting in different.
Sculpting?
Yeah, sculpting. Yes, I do. I work with clay and so I do some clay sculptures. Sometimes I do a little wood sculptures. So I
okay,
you know,
those things, like,
yeah,
those huge pots.
Yeah, but mine
is
a little.
That kind of okay.
Mine a little. I do mostly like human faces. I like to do faces a lot. I like to do it's mostly what I do. I do faces, or I do some stuff with my son. I do some animals. I do some things like that. I do clay and wood. So I like to learn about art. I just took a painting class. So I like painting and sculpting and woodworking, and I like working with my hands. You know, I like getting my hands dirty and getting in there and doing fun things like that. So I will spend some time and do things like that. Those are my hobbies. And spending time with my kids. That's my favorite hobby.
Can I give you one suggestion?
Sure.
From time to time, and this is something that I've been reading a lot about from a spiritual guru in India, that spending time with the soil, things like farming or gardening, is really beneficial to the health. So, you know, if you have any beautiful farms or any gardens in your area, then it would be a good time, especially this time of the year. April, May, June is a really good time to, like, get your hands into the soil. I wish I had access, but I'm working 7 days a week. And whenever I get a little bit of time, I do YouTube. So it's just, but
we got to get you to stop working 7 days a week. That's no good. You're not gonna go to where you want to go. You want to go to where you want to go, you got to rest.
When I come down to New York, we'll go to one of the farms, and we'll plant like an actual tree.
Put our hands into dirt. I like that.
Yes, put our hands into dirt. Joe, do you remember that day when you decided to, you know, start a venture of your own, that particular day? And what life events led to this major decision? And what skills at that point did you bring to your business?
That is a loaded question, man. All right. So,
and I have more, but, you know, it's not nice to keep very long screen.
That's a loaded question. So what I'll tell you is this. When I decided to start my business, I had my first business. I was 17. I had like 25 bouncers working for me. And I was a bouncer, you know, in a club. And then
really.
And then I decided that I would stop doing that and go into military. I went in the military. When I came out, I worked for the Department of Defense for a while. Then I worked for a biomedical engineering company, then an IT company. And then I decided that I would start an IT company because I saw that the little businesses were getting screwed over and the big businesses they took great care of them. And there was nobody really helping the smaller businesses use their IT to really grow. And so I started focusing on that. And in the beginning, I was a terrible business person. I was really bad. And it took me a while to really learn how to run a business. So the skills that I brought were all my technical skills. I was a great technician. I was a terrible business person. And so it took me about 2.5-3 years to really learn how to run a business effectively. And then when I did, then I was really able to not just help my clients, but help my team, grow my team, help my staff. It was very good. But that's, you know, that's really what brought me to it.
It's been a journey. So did you, like, do military training
Like, I did. I spent nine years in the Army altogether.
So, like, you trained and you served in the we have one more podcast, and that's going to be entirely, because that is something that I genuinely find, you know, I'm not a disciplined person. Even today, I kind of have a gist of the address of how to be disciplined, but military lifestyle is just next level. And I think when I was 18, I should have gone there. I think that's the place I belonged. I was a lazy 126 kg, which is 270 pounds approx, kid that time. So that's another episode we have to do, because, you know, military teaches a lot.
It does, sure does.
Wow, so military is from where discipline comes in.
But then you have to maintain it, because what happens is a lot of people go in the military and then they're put into the process of the military, because the military is really just a complex process, right?
Yeah.
And then they leave that process and they lose their discipline. Because that the process of the military is what enforces the discipline, right? It's the process itself. It's not even the people. You could take very undisciplined people and put them through the process of the military and they will become very disciplined, because there are real consequences if you're not, right?
Yes, yes.
Like life and death, real consequences. And I think that in our business, we don't relate to the consequences of not being disciplined. And so part of running an effective business is you do have to have a measure of discipline.
Yeah, it's like saying that if I am lazy and I procrastinate, I'll be asleep forever. So that's one of the consequences, that if I don't take things seriously, I'll be asleep forever, because somebody will just shoot me or somebody will attack me, and I will not have that sharp mind to sense if something is wrong. Interesting. I'm curious to know one last thing, and for the audience to also know a bit about the five components of a business machine and what it takes to build one, since, you know, start, grow, and manage is helping entrepreneurs and freelancers
build that machine. Yeah, so when you look at machine in dictionary, same way we did with hustle, right? It's an apparatus using or applying mechanical power and having several parts, each with definite function, and together for performing a particular task, right? So it's this idea of together performing a particular task. So building a machine requires building a team, and that team are the parts of your machine, right? And to have a machine, what you need is you need a defined customer avatar, right? Like, who is your ideal client? You need to know what that is if you want to have a machine. You need to know what's the problem that you solve for that client. If you don't know what the problem that you solve for that client is, you don't have a machine. You're self-employed, but every time you have to do it different, right? If you want a machine, you need to know who has that problem and how do you solve it. You also need a program for solving the problem so that you're solving the same problem over and over again. That's what a machine does, right?
Actually,
it solves
yeah.
the same problem over and over again. You need repeatable sales and marketing, and you need repeatable delivery. Those are the five things that you need to have a business machine. If you have those five things, you can really do it. And to get those five things, what you have to do is you have to define what's your vision, what's your mission, what are the values of your business, what's your strategy, and you have to have a plan. The way I look at it is it's kind of like this. Your vision is your destination, is where you're going, right? Your mission is like the car that's going to take you there, right? Your values are like the driver of the car. They're really going to help you get from here to there, right? That's what the values are going to do. The strategy is like the GPS. It's going to tell you turn left, turn right, turn left, turn right. That's what's going to guide you, right? And without a plan, if you go on a trip without a plan, what hotel are you going to stay in? Where are you going to sleep? What are you, you know, what, where are you going to eat? If you go without a plan, it's not going to go well. You know, where are you going to stop for gas? If you don't plan, you'll run out of gas between stops, right?
Yeah.
So that's kind of, when I look at, those are the things that you need to build that machine, right? And if you have those, then you'll really get to a place. And then there's what you need to actually get stuff done, right? If you want to get things done, you need accountability, a team, and you need tools. And so those last three things, that's what we provide. We provide accountability. We provide a team of people that are going to help you. And we provide the tools. That's it.
So
that's
the whole thing. Do you also recruit for
clients? No.
Okay,
what we do is we provide a group of other business owners that you can come to and will help you think about, you know, your own business. Okay. But that's the team that we provide.
Okay. This is like networking, sort of.
Well, it's not really networking. What we're doing is it's more like a mastermind, right? So we meet once
a week. Mastermind, word, yes.
Yeah, so we meet once a week, and then you come with your business challenges, and there's other business owners, and they kind of can tell you what they've done about those same challenges. And having that team and having a brain trust that you can bring those challenges to is super helpful.
That's an interesting concept. Well, I've really learned a lot from this session, and I'll have to watch this again to, you know, make some notes about some really insightful things. What I liked is that, you know, we covered everything, business and a bit of personal life, and I think that's what makes the journey more meaningful and a bit more joyful.
100%.
And yeah, it just brings a smile on your face, even when you're working. You sometimes just get those memories of time well spent in your personal life, or a happy client which, you know, gave you a call or something. You sometimes kind of revisit those beautiful
all the time, you know, when you help a client take their business and make it 100% or 200% or 300% bigger, right, over a period of 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, whatever it takes, to watch that growth, to watch their joy, to watch them spend time with their family, to watch them, you know, really, I'm working with a single mother now, and she couldn't spend time with her son. And now she has four employees and she can spend time with her son. That's the real joy for me.
And as I mentioned earlier in this episode, that, you know, you're one of the very, very few people who is on LinkedIn sharing pictures of, you know, going out with family. And I've seen that the message you're trying to give to your clients, that, you know, I'm an actual human being, not a machine that is just working from Monday to Friday or Saturday, but it also shows that you've got a personal life. And to people like me, it just inspires that, you know, career is not everything. Yes, in a phase of life, it might be, but there is also a very crucial importance to give more time to yourself and to your near and dear ones who matter the most. So any final thoughts?
Well, for me, it's...
Yeah, yeah.
I was gonna say, for me, it's always about remembering that, you know, somebody loves you out there, you know, and so always stay in that state. Don't being an entrepreneur is tough.
It is.
Right. But if it's in your heart, there's nothing that can replace it. So don't get stuck. Build the machine, or it will be a long, hard life. I think that's it. I think that's what I got.
That's a wise word to, you know, end the session. Thanks a lot. And I'm sure we have so much in common, and I'm sure the audience has also enjoyed, and the audience wants to hear more from you. So maybe next time we should talk about the military stuff and what goes on, and what do you take away for the rest of your life from that experience? Yeah. Because that is something a lot of people have not experienced.
Awesome.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Namaste. Thanks a lot.
Namaste.